I'm here in San Francisco. I'm with Adam Volmer. We're here at Faraday Bikes. I mean, this is awesome because the last time I visited, you guys were in Palo Alto.
Yep.
Now you're expanding. The shop is crazy. In fact, we were just looking at all these different revisions you've been working on. So, of course, we're talking about the Faraday Porteur, and that is the prototype I looked at the last time we were together. And we have come so far. Clearly, you've gone through a number of revisions. Have you named this? Does this have a name? Does she?
This guy?
It's, like old, it's a guy.
Old Glory. I don't know. It's like this bike has been through a lot.
But she still looks amazing, and I can't wait to see what you've got back here. So take us on a tour. Show us the office here.
Yeah, okay. Well, come on in. So the team is cranking. We're hard at work. We're just a couple of months away from shipping our first bikes right now, which is super exciting.
Yeah.
A little stressful as well, but not in a bad way.
Yeah.
So Victor over here is working on our battery pack right now.
Oh, awesome.
Hugo's doing some, what are you working on?
Hey, Hugo.
CAD work, controller housing.
CAD work.
Oh, man. That.
Carouseling bikes. Making sure people get the right size.
Look at this. What is all this up here? It's like a master flow chart.
This is like crunch time. This is the date so you can be like, man, we're 2 feet away from shipping.
And you've got a little gong here for that this day, that special day.
Yeah, every time we sell a bike, we
ring the gong. Oh, my gosh.
We rang the gong this morning.
Sweet. Oh, you were telling me. Yeah. So,
yeah.
You know, being right downtown San Francisco, it's a pretty big bike culture. A lot of people are out here riding around and actually doing it. So you said someone came in, they were on another electric bike, and they were like, look at this thing. This is awesome. And they picked one up from you guys.
So it was super cool. We had a guy come in, and we made a lot since that bike you saw over there, the original, we made a lot of upgrades. So we upgraded the drivetrain, the battery pack. Components. It's kind of like the bike looks the same, but like almost everything is different.
Well, take us through it. So, you know, I did a review on this and you can see it like test written and stuff, but it's always great to hear it, you know, from the team that's building this thing.
In person, yeah.
Yeah.
So this is the latest and greatest here. And there's some things about it that are very prototypey. This is still 3D printed. You can see it's plastic.
Yep.
The frame is not painted, obviously. But this is pretty true to the production bike. And so the thing that caught this gentleman's eye yesterday who came by was the belt drive. So we added a belt drive here, which is an upgrade we're super excited about. It's just, it's totally quiet. Oops, there it goes.
Oh, we're on right now.
Totally nice. Smooth. And so he was like, well, belt drive, I got to come and try it out. And he tried it out. He liked it so much, he bought one today. So we got to ring the gong today.
That's sweet. And, you know, talk a little bit about the drive system. You've mentioned that this thing, it offers like a pedal assist modes. There are two of them. One's a little bit more power, the other one's a little bit less power. But you've got, it's sort of like cadence and torque sensing, is that right?
Yeah, so we use a torque sensing bottom bracket, and it can sense torque or cadence, right? So you can kind of pick and choose which you want. And we have this controller here on the handlebar that lets you sort of toggle through the modes. So you can turn it off. One thing I really, I get confused on when I ride some e-bikes is sort of like big pop-up electrical screens, right, where you kind of have to, like, you're riding in traffic and watching out for cars and people and cats and also kind of, like, dialing through a menu. And, and it's kind of like the way you shift gears. You just click a little thumb button. And we wanted shifting gears kind of electronically to be just as easy. So this guy, you just click it off or low or high. And basically what it does, the way it's set up right now, is low is sort of a 250-watt mode. Mm-hmm. And high is a 350-watt mode. And down the line, we're going to be putting out an upgrade that'll let you kind of go in and change that and customize that and fine-tune it. But right now, it's just kind of a really quick kind of on-the-fly way to change how the bike feels. Or, you know, if you're in traffic, you can just turn it off and ride it like a regular bike.
Very cool. Well, can you? One of the things, you know, this is the Porteur. So you showed me earlier there was like a rack or something that kind of worked with the front. Is that?
Yeah.
Can you show that? Is that top secret?
It's a little top secret, but I'll give you a sneak preview.
Preview. Okay.
Yeah, a little bit.
Sweet.
So one thing we had this big a pull in array. We had this big cargo rack on the original bike.
Beautiful.
And originally it was huge, actually. This is quite big. So we made it a little smaller, but it attaches in the front right there.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing we found is that a lot of people loved it, and they were like, the idea of a front-mounted rack that's on the frame of the bike, you can carry a lot of weight, it's awesome.
Yeah.
And some people just didn't, it wasn't their thing, right? They wanted a rear-mounted rack, or they just wanted a lighter weight bike. And rather than locking people into one thing or the other, we kind of tweaked the design in a way to let you kind of get the best of both worlds. So you can have the bike as is right now with no rack, basically.
Yep. It just looks like a regular bike, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or we have this little piece here that it's hard to do with one hand.
Just kind of,
Is that kind of?
Got it.
Let me see. two hands makes this much easier. So this guy just clicks in.
Over the cables like that.
Like that?
Oh, it's so easy.
Over the cables?
Mm-hmm.
And then the rack, this is a very prototype version of the rack. Just welded together pieces of material here with a plywood on it. But it'll look just like the original one there.
Beautiful.
This guy just drops in just like that.
Oh, sweet. And then you've got like that little screw right there.
And
so
a little bolt.
So you preserve that, you know, the utility aspect of this bike, but without having to carry it all the time.
You can kind of just sort of take it or leave it, right? So kind of whichever one you want. So we really like that because you can still, we've put 50 pounds in this thing.
Wow. It's a lot of cats right there.
It's a lot of cats. But it rides great. It really, really rides. When you have the rack mount or the weight mounted on the frame, not the wheel, it rides great. So again, this will be basically an identical sort of tray to the original one. And then the tubes coming out here will have the same kind of really graceful, nice curved shape.
Okay.
Powder coated to match the frame. And we're getting samples of that in the next couple weeks.
Yeah, man. Well, I came just, it's almost like the perfect time here. You got this final prototype that we're looking at. You know, sans paint, but beautiful, beautiful bike. It was tons of fun to ride. And I love that you've upgraded the motor. Now it's the 350 watts, so you're getting a little bit of extra power, a little bit of extra speed. The battery design has always been impressive to me, just the way it's kind of integrated, and it just, you almost don't even notice that it's an electric bike. And of course, that belt drive system. So I can't wait for this to come out. I really appreciate the kind of behind the scenes tour, even showing you sneak peeks and stuff. It's a great team. It was fun to meet everyone. And that's it. Yeah. Faraday, San Francisco. Thanks, Adam.
Bye, guys.